familiar sight here at Lake Okeechobee near Port Mayaca. A blue-green algae bloom is hugging the shoreline. Recent test results show the bloom is toxic.
The toxin levels in at least one of the samples was fairly high. It's something you wouldn't want to be swimming in or fishing in, or you definitely want to avoid contact with it.
Dr. Malcolm McFarland is a researcher at FAU Harbor Branch Oceanographic Institute in Fort Pierce.
So this is the freezer where we store a lot of our samples that we collect from the field.
He says the algae spotted in Lake Okeechobee can be very patchy, which means a large portion of the lake is probably fine.
But you can get highly concentrated mats of the toxic algae in specific locations that you would probably want to avoid.
Mark Perry is the executive director of the Florida Oceanographic Society in Stuart. He also checks for algae blooms, especially along the South Fork of the St. Lucie River. He says, as of now, he has not found any blooms in Martin County.
So in our coast, we're pretty safe from that bloom at the current time that's in the lake. So that's where we are pretty much right now.
But you're keeping an eye out on it.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, any time that you've got this kind of toxic blue-green algae in a water body like Lake Okeechobee, we have to be concerned of how it affects people or the environment and that kind of thing.
There have been no recent discharges from the lake. Some are concerned those discharges carry the toxic blooms into the river, but experts urge we should also focus on other possible sources.
We have to be cautious about what we are doing to cause those algae blooms. Are we producing too much nutrient inflow to the surface waters like the Lake Okeechobee? And if that's the case, we should stop or control what we're doing.
Now, the governor's newly appointed blue-green algae task force will meet for the first time tomorrow morning in Tallahassee. That group will focus on finding some solutions to this blue-green algae problem. Reporting live in Port Mayaca, Angela Rozier, WPBF 25 News.